What is a slow slip event? In New Zealand, the Pacific and Australian tectonic plates meet along a series of major fault lines. In the North Island, the Pacific plate dives or subducts westward beneath the North Island's east coast along the Hikurangi Trough. It forms New Zealand's largest and most active fault, the Hikurangi Subduction Zone. The plates move towards each other along this fault. In the deepest parts of the Hikurangi Subduction Zone, the rocks are hotter and the plates can move past each other slowly and continuously. But at shallower depths, the plates are more brittle, and the friction between them causes them to temporarily lock together. Over time, the stress at the locked zone builds up. Every few years, the plates temporarily become unstuck and a slow slip event occurs. This releases the built-up stress and the Earth's crust rebounds. A slow slip event is like an earthquake because energy is released along a fault line, but this energy is released over weeks to months during a slow slip event, unlike an earthquake, which lasts only a few seconds. You can see from the GPS sites how the land moves. Earthquakes on the subduction zone. Sometimes the movements between the plates aren't slow, but sudden and fast, resulting in damaging earthquakes. Large earthquakes can occur on the subduction zone after the plates have been locked together for a long time, perhaps for hundreds or even thousands of years. Over many years of locking, enough stress and pressure builds up on the fault that eventually the fault breaks, allowing the plates to suddenly slip past each other in an earthquake. Can a slow slip event cause a major earthquake? Slow slip events often occur next to the parts of the plate boundary where earthquakes occur. Scientists are investigating how a slow slip event can increase stress on the locked segment of the plate boundary and whether or not this can influence the timing of future earthquake ruptures. Once scientists can better understand this relationship between slow slip events and earthquakes, we might be able to use slow slip events for better earthquake forecasting in the future. However, it's important to know that we have observed dozens of slow slip events in New Zealand that have not triggered large earthquakes. Researching slow slip events in New Zealand. Studying slow slip events could tell us a lot about how and why New Zealand's biggest earthquakes occur. GNS Science geophysicists are working with other international researchers to resolve where slow slip events happen and what effect they have on the plate boundary fault. Here you can see a large locked zone covering much of the central and lower North Island. This locked zone is where pressure and stress are currently building up that could be relieved in a future earthquake. Next to it is a slow slip zone, and then next to that is a steadily creeping zone. GNS Science is involved in several large international projects to investigate the causes of slow slip and locking on the subduction zone in New Zealand. Because the Hikurangi plate boundary has shallower slow slip events than elsewhere in the world, making it the best place globally to undertake this research.